Do you think your dog has parasites? There are certain clues that can indicate that our best friend has worms. Depending on the type of infection it's suffering, internal or external, the symptoms can include vomiting, diarrhea, lack of appetite, or the fact that your dog is continuously scratching its body. In any of these situations, it's advisable to start deworming so that your dog can recover and feel much better. Parasites in dogs. Many dogs have internal or external parasites, and this is because these animals live around us and can end up harming our health and our pet's health too. In fact, it's common for newborn puppies to be infected by parasites and can get their first infection at a very early age, provoking vomit, diarrhea, loss of appetite, or, in severe cases, can cause the death of the animal. This is why it's important to deworm a dog from the very beginning in order to protect them from infectious agents that can put their lives at risk. To learn the vaccination calendar, you should go to the vets so they can give you the proper indications, as this will depend on the characteristics of each animal, breed, weight, age, etc. This will determine the appropriate age when you should start deworming. Tough in general, it should never exceed their first 6 weeks of life. Internal parasites. To deworm a dog that's infected by internal parasites, you'll have to go to the vet so that he or she can prescribe a medicine that will help fight this infection. The most clear symptom that your dog has this problem is that you'll notice it's more apathetic, doesn't want to eat, has diarrhea and looks down. All these signs can be a warning of internal parasites and that it must be treated. To proceed when you deworm your dog, there are several medicines. Some of them will depend on the worm that's living in our pet's organism. Syrups or pills with 2 dozen are adequate to deworm them, and our vet will indicate which is more convenient for our pet. In general terms, you should know that the most efficient are those that contain components such as parenteral parmoid, fenbendazole, praziquantel, and metronidazole. It's not necessary for the medicine to have all of these components, but it should have at least 2 of them so the deworming is effective and definitive. These products are administered orally, and it's recommendable for them to be prescribed by a vet. Once it's clean, you'll have to follow adequate hygiene measures that will help your dog avoid having these worms again, such as applying anti-mosquito repellent on your dog's neck during summer. External parasites. The hair and skin of your pet can also be infected by parasites. Frequent grooming is a good way to avoid them, although it is difficult to keep our pet free of parasites, especially if you spend a lot of time outdoors. To get rid of external parasites from your dog, you can use various medications that should also be prescribed by your vet. These methods include the following. Pipettes. This dog deworming agent is perfect to fight the infection and prevent it from future infections. Apply the dose on their neck carefully, taking care that your dog doesn't lick it off. Anti-parasite collar. There are also special collars that are placed on the animal's neck and have medication that can get rid of parasites living in their bodies and prevent the proliferation of another infection. Injection. Depending on the severeness of the illness, it's also possible for the vet to prescribe a more effective and drastic method, a subcutaneous injection. With this method, you'll get a more immediate effect and your animal will stop feeling discomfort and itching more quickly. You should know that the most common parasites and worms that could put your dog's health at risk are fleas, mites, lice, and ticks. The latter are more dangerous and they can infect our pet with diseases such as pyroplasmosis. This is why you should not only deworm your pet when it has the symptoms of being infected, but you'll also have to prevent an infection. How to deworm a dog at home. Apart from the methods mentioned above, there are also natural options that can end with these parasites and make their quality of life better. To attack the infection correctly, it's important to know what kind of worms or parasites we are talking about in order to get rid of them effectively. If your dog has ticks. If the infection is due to parasites, you should know that apple cider vinegar is an ideal option to fight this condition. The acid in this product is corrosive for ticks and will help kill them effectively. To try this remedy, you only need to mix 1/2 liter of water and 1/2 liter of apple cider vinegar. You should make sure the amounts are always the same. Bathe your dog with this mix or dampen a cloth with it and scrub it on your dog's fur. If your dog has fleas. If you notice that your dog has fleas, the best way to get rid of them is by applying lavender oil, as its aroma works as an efficient natural repellent for these animals. To do so, you'll only have to mix a small amount of water with this oil and put it in a sprayer, spray it on your dog and you'll be able to kill the fleas as well as giving your dog a delightful scent. If the dog has intestinal worms. If you detect that your animal is suffering from internal worms, you'll have to give it an oral remedy to treat the infection directly and make your dog's illness diminish. Cod liver oil is a good option as it's rich in vitamin A, a nutrient that helps get rid of parasites. To apply this natural remedy, you only need to mix this oil with the animal's food so that it will eat it with its usual feed. If your pet is not hungry, you should put it in a syringe and give it to it directly in its mouth, waiting for your dog to swallow it. It's a good method to make sure your dog has taken its medicine. How often should you deworm your dog? The first thing we should know when we should start to deworm our dog. As a general rule, it should be before your dog is 6 weeks old, we should give it its first dose and give it a second amount 2 weeks later. During its life, we should repeat this process every 3 or 4 months, depending on the risk your dog has of being infected. This will depend on whether your dog lives in a flat or it has a garden and is in contact with other animals. All these indications will be given to you by your vet, who will establish a jab calendar according to your pet's lifestyle. Tips. If you are not sure what medication to use, see your veterinarian as a parasite can seriously complicate the health of your pet.